Consolidating means that any files you've imported, whether they are within the library or you import them with keep in place optioned, then those files will be searched for by the consolidate feature and entered into your library. So if you imported files with leave in place sectioned and you didn't optimize or create proxy media, then those files will only be linked by Final Cut. If in this case you were to archive your library, any files imported while this option was placed will not be in your library. So Consolidate will go and find those files and put them in your library for you. Just as a note here, if you import files from iPhoto or from iTunes, no matter what selection you have when you import them, whether you selected them as leave in place or copy files into the library, Final Cut will always put a copy of the iTunes music or audio or the iPhoto photo, and it will always put a copy of that into your library. So the process of consolidating is to select your library, come to the file menu, select consolidate library files, and any clips now that were imported into Final Cut that were not imported into the library will now be brought into the Sydney Harbour Clips Library. And if we say okay to that, what it's told us is there are no files to consolidate. So we know that all of the clips are in fact in the library. Since we now know that all of our media is currently consolidated into this library, let's now import another clip and we'll import it and retain it outside the library. And then we'll see how we can consolidate those clips into the library with the consolidation function. So what we're going to do now is to import a clip. We will right click on the event, import media, and if we go to the desktop, I've got on the desktop a test JPEG or a photo. We'll import that and we will leave the files in place, so we won't copy them into the library and we won't ask for transcoded media. Now let's import that. And now that that's in the library, if we go to the Finder now and look for the Library Sydney Harbour Clips and right click on that and show the package contents, and there is a Sydney Harbour Clips folder within the library. So if we expose that now, we can see the original media here. And if we look down in this original media, we'll see right at the bottom here the test JPEG, and there's a little curly arrow on that telling us that this is only a shortcut or a link to the original file outside the library. If we right click on that now and show original, we can see that the original is on the desktop. If now we select the Sydney Harbour Clips Library and we come to the File menu and select Consolidate and consolidate into that library. Now when we go to the Finder and we look in all the libraries and inside the Sydney Harbour Clip Library, right click, Show Package Contents. If we now look, the test JPEG no longer has the curly arrow on the side of it, so that it now actually resides or is contained within the library. And to be clear, even though there is a full clip in the library, the original is still on the desktop because Final Cut never affects your original footage. When we check, we can see that the original is still on the desktop. And why is this important? Because if we now want to archive this library, the Sydney Harbour Clips Library, then we now know that all of our clips are now within that library. If you recall, in the import and organization tutorial in the advanced section, there was a lesson on finder management where you managed your clips into folders, and then eventually those folders were archived to external hard disks. So if you follow that process now and use the consolidation feature, you'll be assured that all of your footage and all of the associated clips will be archived to the external disks, and you won't have missing media.